So my name is Jeremy Willsey. I'm a postdoc in Matt State's lab at UCSF. We actually just recently moved here from Yale University. And so our lab works on trying to understand the genetics of autism, with the idea that if you can understand the genetics of autism, this will give you a window into the biology of autism, which is something that has largely still trying to be worked out. Yes, we're interested in using genetics to understand the biology of autism, but the ultimate drive of it is to translate that to treatment. I mean, that's really the goal of all of this, is that you understand the perturbations that are happening during the pathogenesis of autism so that you can treat them, or that you can prevent, or that you can give people information on risk factors and things like that. So that's definitely the biggest drive, is to translate our findings to the clinic. So I did my undergraduate at Simon Fraser University in Burnaby, British Columbia, Canada. And there was my first exposure to working in a research lab. I was very lucky to work in a lab that mentored me extremely well and really developed my passion for both research and being involved in the research community. It made me realize that it was more than just the projects, that it was really a community of people that gives you a lot of support and there's a lot of collegial relationships there. There's kind of two parallel approaches in our lab, one of which is the primary goal, which is identification of genes, and the second part is using those genes to understand the biology. And that's really where my work has focused. And so one of the challenges is that you have this large number of genes. There's probably upwards of 1,000 genes that contribute to autism risk. And when you look at this list of genes you have, they appear to be relevant to all parts of the biology. You know, it can be synapse development, synapse function, brain development, gene regulation, gene expression modification, all kinds of things. And so just looking at them at face value, it's very hard to say, gotcha, that's what's going wrong. And so one of the ways that we've worked on solving that problem is using data from the developing human brain. The idea being that autism is largely a disorder of the brain, and that using this information is going to be most relevant. So the part of it is generating the data sets, processing the data from raw data to a final format that you can begin your downstream analyses of, and then really troubleshooting the analysis.
I don't know, it's an interesting question. I've wondered about that. I think it's really tough to start to draw too many conclusions from the shape of this, especially since we're arbitrarily choosing network connection.
Matt's lab in particular is fantastic for what I would like to get out of lab, which is an extremely collaborative lab. We all work together very closely. We're all very close, both in and out of the lab. And I think for me that translates to happiness, because you do spend a lot of time in the lab, and particularly during really busy periods, it can take up a lot of time in your life. And so having that group of people that you were close with personally and collegially makes a huge difference. It just in daily happiness. So I think that lots of different types of people are successful in science, and it's really just a matter of finding the right environment for you. So to that extent, I would say the best thing that someone can do is just get in a lab, start working, and start getting research experience. I think until you're in that situation, you don't know if you're going to really enjoy research, if it's going to be something for you. And the more labs that you can get experience in, the more you'll realize what you want your role in research to be. The questions that we're trying to answer are very interesting to me, and also the fact that we're, in answering these questions, we're hoping to help people. So for me, those things are particularly driving.
So maybe that suggests that your strongest areas of gene expression correlation have both positive and negative correlations? Kind of makes sense, you have twice the connections.
I really do like making sense of data. And in the autism field right now is a particularly exciting time, because gene discovery efforts have accelerated substantially. And so we have a large biological substrate to work with. And then coupled with the fact that there's new revolutionary techniques being brought to the forefront, where you now have gene expression from the human brain across the course of development, it's an amazing data set when you just look back on, or just take a step back and look at the data set on its own. The fact that you can then combine that with a large number of genes associated with autism and other genomics data sets is just amazing. And it's a time where we can really make big strides forward in terms of understanding the neurobiology of autism. So I think that part of it for me is very exciting.